Howdy. Welcome to episode 4 of the Rig Tour series. Today we are going to go over the simple power system I use to live full-time on the road in my Overland camper. Let's go. The foundation of my power system is the PowerBox 135 by Dakota Lithium. This is a 135 amp hour battery in a waterproof case with easy access terminals, a front-facing USB and USB-C outlet, and an included 300 watt inverter with two 110 outlets and four USB ports. It comes with a handy wall charger and can be hooked up using alligator clamps. In my rig, this battery is used to power all the primary items, including the Max Air fan, the portable heater, and the 12 volt refrigerator. If you're following along, yes, I swapped out the Yeti cooler. I'll talk more about the new fridge in another video. Occasionally, I'll plug my laptop in too. For smaller items, like my iPhone and Kindle, I use a ZMI PowerPack 20,000. I bought this for backpacking and it's been awesome for truck camping too. To charge it, I plug it into the cigarette outlet in the cab while driving. You may have noticed that I didn't mention any hardwired lights, and that's because I don't have any. I just use these two rechargeable lanterns, and I like these because I can move them around wherever I need them, including outside. They have a nice warm glow and they last a long time, and I just charge them up on the power brick if they need a boost. I do want to say that power systems are not a one-size-fits-all sort of thing. Everybody's going to have slightly different power needs. Mine are pretty minimal. But that said, at the beginning of this process, I found it super helpful to write down all of the different items that I use that need power, and then figure out what the maximum hourly amp draw for each one of those items could be. Here's my list. Up first, the Max Air fan can draw up to 3 amps an hour at full speed. Next, the 12 volt refrigerator can pull up to 5 amps an hour on max cooling mode. The portable diesel heater can pull up to 3 amps an hour too, but it uses up to 15 amps an hour on startup and shutdown. This is really important because most other portable power systems don't have 12 volt outlets that can handle that much amp draw. Anyway, that brings my total maximum draw to 11 amps. So, with a 135 amp hour battery and some simple division, we can figure out that I could run everything in my camper at full draw for about 12 hours. Okay, but obviously I don't run everything at full power all the time. It's not perfect math, but recently I was off grid for like 3 days and I wasn't using any solar power. By the end of it, my battery monitor was still reading over 50%. It's also rare for me to go more than 3 days without charging, and for that, I use the EcoFlow 160 watt portable solar panel. I'll typically just set it outside of the truck, angled towards the sun. For anyone curious, here's what my wire chart looks like. A disclaimer, I am not an electrician. Please do your own research. This is just how I did it. All right, y'all, I hope this has been helpful for you. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below and I'll do my best to help you out. And as always, if you liked it, like it. And if you really liked it, do come along for the ride. Next week, we're going to be talking about the Chuck Box. So stick around for that. I'll see you then.